General of India, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, one of the most powerful lawyers, appears for Rakesh Asthana. Let's understand what happened in the court. Mr. Rohatgi, a powerful hearing in the court, now an inquiry by the top court. How are we to look at it?
Look, as far as the court is concerned, it has only endorsed the view of the CVC that the matter raises serious concerns about the credibility of the director, and therefore an inquiry is a must. CVC has recorded that regretfully the director did not cooperate in giving proper replies and files, etc. Now the Supreme Court has directed that within 2 weeks the inquiry has to be completed. So once the preliminary inquiry is completed, it will be clear whether the director is guilty of some cognizable offences or not. If he is, then of course there is no way that he can come back, because then it will be a crime. If he is not, then of course he may have something to say. That's where, as far as the court is concerned. As far as Mr. Asthana is concerned, I appeared for Mr. Asthana. We have filed a petition on his behalf, which was not listed today. It is Mr. Asthana's grievance that he is the one who made a complaint to the Cabinet Secretary, which went to the CVC in August of this year, in which Asthana has raised some serious charges. So Asthana's grievance is that the director could be divested of his power, but why should a whistleblower be divested of his power? That's what his grievance is, which will be taken up after the court
resolves. But there is a certain motivated lobby that, along with the opposition, is working in the case. We are seeing Rahul Gandhi outside the CBI headquarters. We are seeing a lobby that also comes to the court and tries to break up the case. How are we to look at it? Because it's more a political battle.
No, madam, as far as I am concerned, I am a lawyer. I don't go by political affiliations. I don't know who's waiting outside where. Whoever has come to me, I will defend that. I don't think that you should go by any of these political things. But let me tell you, in the court, normally when there are political rivalries, you find lawyers belonging to different hues. But in this case, I did not find that the lawyers for the director, etc., were having any political affiliation.
Okay, Mr. Rohatgi,
not in court, okay. Maybe outside the court.
One last question. Mr. Asthana has raised very serious allegations when there is a lot of material against the CBI director. In another letter, which he's also raised questions against Dr. Swami, he's also clarified that he's attacked the CBI in the ED and said there was no work done against Chidambaram in the Aircel Maxis case. He's done work against Robert Wadra. There was windfall gains. How is it that the CBI and the ED overlooked all this evidence that he had collected over the years?
That's, madam, for them to answer, not me.
All right. Very clearly, as the top lawyer of the court, and we're continuing to follow him out as he's, moving out. The point really is simple, that Rakesh Asthana's case is going to be heard on Monday in the Delhi High Court. But clearly, we are getting these last visuals of the former Attorney General, Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, as he's walking out of court, because this is so crucial today, viewers. A final hearing and a final inquiry is going to be there by the CVC, that's going to be headed by a former Supreme Court judge. With Anoop, I'm Rhythm in Delhi for Republic TV.